I get lots of questions from viewers about their AMH levels. In combination with age, AMH is a pretty good predictor of IVF success rates. But what if you are not doing IVF? Will AMH predict success if you are using Clomid or fertility injections with either intercourse or IUI? Great questions. Stay tuned for the answer. Measurement of a woman's AMH level in the blood is a valuable tool for determining the number of eggs remaining in the ovaries. High AMH means there are more eggs remaining, and low AMH levels indicate fewer eggs remaining. During IVF treatment, this is very important. IVF is basically a numbers game. Fertility medications are used during IVF in an attempt to mature multiple eggs in the ovaries at once. These eggs are then removed from the ovaries in a procedure called an egg retrieval. The more eggs we are able to get, the better our chances for finding eggs that will fertilize and develop into healthy embryos that are capable of producing a live birth. Unfortunately, most of the eggs in human beings are abnormal and therefore do not have the ability to produce a live birth. Although IVF generally has the highest chance for pregnancy compared to other treatments, women with low AMH levels tend not to respond to fertility medications as well. Often, they do not reach the point of having an egg retrieval. When they do have an egg retrieval, they average less eggs. High-quality studies indicate that this lowers the chance for having a successful IVF. Do AMH levels predict success if you are being treated with oral fertility medications like Clomid or Letrozole? During these treatments, there are usually only one or a few eggs which mature at once, so egg reserve may not be as important. In order to study this, there are a few important things to remember. First, pregnancy rates for all treatments decrease as women get older. And second, AMH levels decrease in women also as they get older. So, a good study on this topic will control for age. In other words, we need to compare AMH levels in younger women separately from older women. Recently, scientists from the US did just that. They divided women using oral fertility medications into three groups based on their age. Group 1 were women under the age of 35, group 2 were age 35 to 40, and group 3 were over the age of 40. Then they divided them into those that had a low AMH level of less than 1 and compared them to women in the same age groups who had an AMH level of 1 or higher. What did they find? Within each age group, women with a low AMH had the same pregnancy rates and miscarriage rates as those with a higher AMH. Having a low AMH level did not predict a lower success rate with oral fertility meds. What about injections of fertility medications? Usually, when using fertility injections, more eggs mature and are ovulated compared to oral medications. Because more eggs mature, pregnancy rates with injections and IUI are higher than with oral medications. You might expect that AMH would be a better predictor for pregnancy when using injections. In the same study as before, the researchers found that for the two younger age groups, women with lower AMH levels had lower pregnancy rates compared to those with higher AMH levels. The miscarriage rates were the same. In the oldest age group, women over age 40, there was no difference in the pregnancy rates. It seems that as the overall chance for pregnancy declines with age, AMH levels became less important. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this: AMH levels do not predict the chance for pregnancy in women being treated with oral medications like Clomid and Letrozole, regardless of their age. AMH levels do predict lower success rates when using injections in women under the age of 40, but not for older women. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.